Have you ever thought, how do we see the various objects around us? Can you see object in dark? What makes things visible? You must be thinking about light. Which phenomena of light is responsible to make us to see the object? The answer is reflection. It is only when light from an object reflected and enters our eyes that we see the object. Can you tell in which direction the light falling on the surface will reflect it? Let us understand by this activity. Place the mirror vertically on a sheet of paper and trace its edge. Draw a perpendicular line at O, which makes right angle to the edge of the mirror. This dashed line represents the normal. So, normal is a line drawn to the surface of the mirror that makes an angle 90 degree to the mirror. This line is used as a reference point for all the angles. Draw an incident ray with the angle of incidence 30 degree. The angle between incident ray and the normal line is called angle of incident. Place two pins P and Q along the line as shown here. With your eyes at position shown, place two other pins R and S to coincide with the images of P and Q. Remove pins R and S and join the dots left with a straight line. Measure and record angle R. The angle shows is almost 30 degree. Repeat the experiment for the angle 45, 50 and 60 degrees. Record the result in the table. What do you find? You can find that in all cases, angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. Carefully observing the result of the experiment, you will clearly see that the angle of incidence equal to the angle of reflection. This is called the first law of reflection. Now observe incident ray, reflected ray and normal. All these three lines lie on a same plane. So we can say incident ray, reflected ray and the normal at the point of incidence lie in a same plane. We call this as second law of reflection. Again, I am asking the same question. Can you tell in which direction the light falling on the surface will be reflected? I think now you get the answer for this. Yes, light falling on the surface will be reflected in such a way that the angle of incident is equal to the angle of reflection. Do this experiment in your lab and prove the law of reflection for various angles of incidence.